Good day. Here are the top stories of the Manila Times for Wednesday, May 26, 2021. The page one banner headline reads, Most Pinoys prefer US-sourced vaccines. 63% of Filipinos prefer vaccines against the coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19 sourced from the United States or US, showed the first quarter survey for 2021 by the Social Weather Stations. Three vaccine makers eye clinical trials in Philippines. Three more vaccine manufacturers have signified their intention to conduct COVID-19 vaccine clinical trials in the country, according to an official of the Department of Science and Technology. Face-to-face graduation rites disallowed. The Department of Education banned the holding of face-to-face end-of-school year rites for school year 2020 to 2021 to protect learners, teachers, and personnel. Meanwhile, in other news, Robredo studying presidential bid. Vice President Maria Leonor Lenny Robredo said she was studying the feasibility of running for president in 2022. Penalize vaccine sellers, LGUs urged. On Tuesday, Malacañang called on local government units or LGUs to pass an ordinance that will penalize those who will sell COVID-19 vaccines and vaccination shots. Jabs to ease jobless rate, says senators. Also on Tuesday, senators called on the government to speed up the vaccination of workers and other economic frontliners to allow them to return to work amid a report the Philippines has the worst jobless rate in Asia. Gatchalian seeks swift justice for slain teen. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian called for swift justice for Edwin Arnigo, who was killed when police raided a cockpit in Valenzuela on Sunday. In regional news, park truck blamed for doctor's death. A driver of a trailer truck was charged with reckless impudence resulting in homicide and damage to property, police investigators in Tuguegarao City said. In world news, cyber attacks rising globally. A series of high-profile cyber attacks on targets in the West have highlighted the vulnerability of companies and institutions, making the issue a higher public priority, but with no easy solution. In business, budget deficit narrows in April. Higher revenues as a result of income tax payments narrowed the national government budget deficit in April, data released by the Bureau of the Treasury showed on Tuesday. And in sports, Phillim Clarkson wins NBA 6th MOI Award. Utah's Jordan Clarkson, the only player to come off the bench and score 40 points in a game this season, was announced on Monday, Tuesday in Manila, as the NBA 6th Man of the Year, or MOI. Rigoberto Tiglao and Father Anilio Aquino are the featured columnists in the front page of the Times. Tiglao asserts that Aquino abandoned Scarborough. Father Aquino rhapsodizes about the Lady of the Keyboard. In the Times editorial, it is recommended that the government must increase efforts to boost LGU's financial management capacity. Read all about it. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print. Subscribe to our digital edition or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And keep up with the Times. With Eric John C. Kua, this is DeFort Villaseran reporting. Have a great week.